In this video, I talk about switching from spherical coordinates to rectangular coordinates. This could be done with vectors or points. It doesn't matter which, since a vector inevitably points at a point. So the two are almost interchangeable, almost. Okay, so now, as we look at this, I have a vector in red, and it's coming to a point here, indicated by the little yellow arrow, and that point we'll just call x, y, z. And so in order to work this, we need to identify some things. First of all, the length of the vector or the distance between the origin and the point is given by rho. It's the Greek letter rho. It's a Greek R. Go figure, that the R looks like the P and the P looks like the R for the pi. Anyway, so when we describe this, there are a couple things that we can describe it with. The most common way to describe the angles is for phi to be the angle between the z-axis and the vector, or that line connecting the origin to the point. Okay, and so we need some angle that is coming down off of the z, and we're going to call that phi. Now theta, if we were to take and kind of step over the point, or over the entire plane, they're not plane but space, it's a three-dimensional space, a two-dimensional plane. If we were to step on the z-axis and look straight down, so all we saw was a two-dimensional plane, the xy plane, with I'll put positive x there and positive y here just to kind of keep it in line with what we're doing over here. I would see this thing come down, and it would look like this. Okay, and so it's going to be shortened by a certain angle, and that's going to be according to phi, as we looked at it. All right, but it's also going to sweep from positive x towards positive y. It's also going to sweep this angle theta, and so the theta is the angle swept from positive x to the point on the xy plane directly beneath the point. All right, so this is going around from in the positive direction. All right, so we've got a distance and we have two angles. Now, if we split this up and look at it in two different ways, here's one. And so now let me go ahead and we'll stand kind of on the x-axis so that we're looking at the yz plane here for this particular example. If we look at the z and the y here, we notice that we have our point here in our vector, x, y, z. Okay, and we're talking about this angle phi in between here. All right, so now let's go ahead and just kind of finish drawing this rectangle. When we look at this, then what we're really going to be looking at is we're going to be looking at this angle here as well, under the parallel lines implying alternate interior angles are equal theorem. So this is also going to be phi. And now you notice that, well, if I look at it, then the xy, this is the xy plane. So if I take that to be my, oops, I apologize. This is my xy plane. If I take this length in yellow, and then I take my hypotenuse here in blue, then I can say that the cosine of phi is equal to whatever this length here is. Okay, we'll just call that z. So that'll be z over rho. Okay, so now the other side, that's also, by the way, that yellow side is also this side here. Okay, so now we want to find out what the length is on the xy plane here in purple. Well, it's opposite of phi, and so in purple we're going to have the sine of phi, which is equal to xy, or the distance on the xy plane, over rho. Which means if we solve for that, we want to find out how much it projects onto the xy plane. It is rho, the sine of phi, is the length that it projects onto the xy plane. Okay, so first we project it down onto the xy plane. Then, once we're onto the xy plane, we can come back up here to our original here, and we say, okay, well, if it's x, it follows the same idea here. Then this would be x would be the cosine. So x would be the cosine would be in this case it would be whatever we came down with, and so it's going to be I'm going to put x y in absolute value signs to indicate the value or the magnitude of x y. Okay, so that's just going to be that cosine theta, and then y is going to equal whatever our length is in the x y plane times the sine of theta. If we combine all these things together, we notice that xy is equal to rho sine of phi. So now, if we have our vector or our point, then, and I'm going to call this, let's call it P. P is the point. This is the point or the vector. Either way, doesn't matter. Okay, then the point or vector is going to be given by p in the x direction, p in the y direction, p in the z direction. In order to get to the x direction, we have to come down here. First, we got to project onto the xy plane. Okay, and so p of x or p sub x is going to first, we project down on the xy plane, so it's rho sine of phi. Now that we're on the xy plane, we come up here and we see, okay, well, that's the projection onto the xy plane. Multiply that by cosine theta. All right, for py, we're doing the same thing. First, we project down. Then, if we look at up here, we see that we take the sine of theta. Okay, so we just take the sine of theta. Now, on the z-axis, we don't project down. We keep it up there. But now z, as we discussed up here, is simply going to be rho times the cosine of phi. And so that's going to be the conversion from spherical coordinates to rectangular coordinates. In vector form, this will look like this. P of x, P of y, P of z. And the vector will be rho sine phi cosine theta, then rho, whoop. Rho sine phi sine theta, and then finally rho cosine phi. And that'll be your vector.